In this video, we'll be tackling question number one from the 2023 Alibaba Global Mathematics Competition Final. Let's dive in. Given a sequence, an plus 1 equals an plus square of an divided by n squared, a1 equals 2 over 5. Prove that for any natural number n, an is less than 1. So let's start from a1. Because a1 equals 2 over 5, so a1 is bigger than 0. Now let's look at the equation. So this equation is what we call the recurrence relation for the sequence. The term an plus 1 is determined by the preceding term an, plus a little bit extra from square of an divided by n squared. So that means a2 equals a1 plus a1 squared divided by 1 squared. Because a1 is bigger than 0, so then a2 is also bigger than 0. Then a3 is bigger than 0, and so on. So we have an is bigger than 0 for all natural number n. Then let's look at this term, this part. Then we have an squared over n squared. Because an is bigger than 0, so then this whole thing is also bigger than 0. Now let's look at the equation. Because this part is bigger than 0, so then an is less than an minus 1, an plus 1. So then we have this result. So that's an is less than an plus 1. Now let's write down this equation. We're going to work on the equation. Okay, so here, given equation an plus 1 equals an plus square of an divided by n squared. So now first, let's move this term to the left-hand side. So then an plus 1 minus an, it equals, for an squared, we're going to put an times an. So next, so let's write down the first an. Then for the second an, we can use an plus 1 replace it. Then here times an plus 1, then divided by n squared. Because an is less than an plus 1 from this result, so then here is less than. So now let's write down the result. So this difference is less than this part. So then we have this result. So the an plus 1 minus an less than an times an plus 1 divided by n squared. So next, both sides divided by this product. And here, just an plus 1 minus an divided by the product an times an plus 1. Because this part is bigger than 0, the product is bigger than 0, so this inequality sign is unchanged. So here just less than 1 over n squared. So now let's split this fraction into two parts and simplify. Then we have 1 over an minus 1 over an plus 1, then less than 1 over n squared. And we have this result. So that means when n equals 2, so then we have 1 over a2 minus 1 over is 3, then less than 1 over 2 squared. So if n equals 3, then we have 1 over a3 minus 1 over a4, then less than 1 over 3 squared. Then for n equals 4, then here 1 over a4 minus 1 over a5, then less than 1 over 4 squared. Then we have for n minus 1, then 1 over a n minus 1 minus 1 over a n, less than 1 over n minus 1 squared. Next, we can add in all the left-hand sides together and all the right-hand sides together. When adding all the left-hand sides together and simplify, so let's see. So let's see, these two canceled, these two cancel, then this term cancel with one term here. Then this term cancel the term right before here. So then the only terms left on the left-hand side is the first term, 1 over a2, and the last term, minus 1 over an. So now let's write down the result. So then here, just adding all the left-hand sides together and the right-hand sides together. So then we have the following. So then just 1 over, then just 1 over a2 minus this one, 1 over an. Then less than, then adding all the right-hand sides together. And here just 1 over 2 squared plus 1 over 3 squared plus 1 over 4 squared. Then here just 1 over n minus 1 squared. Okay, so now let's look at here. So here we have a finite sum. So then it's less than the infinite sum, which is 1 over 2 squared plus 1 over 3 squared plus 1 over 4 squared, the infinite sum. And because this one starting from 2, so if we want to starting from 1, so then we're just adding 1 here. So then this one equals just 1 over 1 squared, then write the rest of the part, then plus 1 over 2 squared, 3 squared. Because we're adding the term 1, then outside with the minus 1. So now let's look at this part, the part inside the parentheses, the infinite sum, which is famous Basel problem. Now it has a closed form solution. So this sum just equals pi squared over 6. Then here we have minus 1. So now let's write down the result. So we have it's a difference is less than this part. Okay, so then here's the result. So then we have 1 over a2 minus 1 over an is less than pi squared over 6 minus 1. So now we need to figure out what is a2. So then a2 equals a1 plus a1 squared over 1 squared. A1 equals 2 over 5. Then here, just plus 2 over 5 squared. Then simplify, that's 14 over 25. So now let's use this result to replace a2 here. Then we have the following. So then here just 1 over this number, 14 over 25, then minus 1 over an. This part, then less than pi squared over 6 minus 1. Then move this term to the other side, then move these two terms to this side. Then here, just 1 over an is bigger than this one simplified, that's 25 over 14. Then minus pi squared over 6, then plus 1. So then you can check it. So this expression is bigger than 1. So then we have this result. So then we have 1 over an is bigger than 1. Then next, both sides times an. Then because an is bigger than 0, so then this inequality sign is unchanged. So then an is less than 1. So then we just prove this question. Thanks for watching.